What up, D-League? Welcome to week four of Berks' weekly preview. Just wanted to say thank you to everyone for giving me feedback last week. It was very positive. A lot of good jobs. Keep up the good work. Nice job, Berks. And then there was some from my dear friend Trav. Shorten the fucking intro. Lose the mad music. You have the on-screen personality of an autistic person. Your points are asinine. On an unrelated note, Trav spent most of his fantasy weekend being sodomized by Jamie to break his undefeated streak. Couldn't happen to a nicer guy. And that brings us into our next segment. It's something I'd like to do each week, is hand out awards based on the prior week's performance. I'm going to just start out with two and see what people think. Our first award goes to Cobblehead.
I'll take the rapists for 200.
This week's rapist of the week is Jamie.
The cock of the walk.
Jamie laid a monumental beatdown on Trav. This was almost bad enough to land Trav our next award, but he came up just shy. Trav was coming into this game undefeated. We'll see this week how he rebounds. His schedule is actually pretty tough. Our next award is actually going to be the biggest loser. This week's biggest loser is Dan. The only way to make the Toilet Bowl match of the week any worse is to also suffer the league's worst defeat in it. Dan suffered a 59-point ass-whooping to Adam's ragtag group. For those who didn't get a chance to see Dan's performance last week, I've put together some of the highlights for you. Not one of Dan's guys reached their projected points, and Dan has still failed to acquire a real quarterback. Keep up the good work, Danielson. Alright, first match we've got Any Given Sunday versus Mavericks. Colin's coming into this match 3-0. Dan's coming into this match 0-3. You know, Colin's on a hot streak. Last week he laid the wood to me. This week he's got Dan in his sights. You know, I don't know what saddens me more, Colin being undefeated at this point or picking Dan to win this game. You know, Colin's choosing to cut off his nose to spite his face this week. He's starting two people who shouldn't be in a starting lineup and arguably on a roster at all at wide receiver this week. In order for him to get into the finals, he can't get tripped up by bottom-of-the-barrel teams. He had a whole week to fix this issue, and he's choosing to roll the dice with Tate and Hayward Bay this week. I personally don't think it pays off. I'm going to take Dan to win this game. Alright, next up we have Cobblehead versus Any Given Sunday. Jamie takes on Nate and his incredibly original team name this week. You know, at this pace, Nate's going to need a lot of lube to get through this season. And Jamie's going to bring what little thunder he has this week again and probably lay it to Nate. You know, it doesn't take much roster analyzing for me to conclude that Nate is just fucked this week. His entire roster was playing the Bills, he still wouldn't win this game. So, in the end, Nate, hate to see you go to 0-4, but I got a feeling you're on your way, man. And nothing pains me more to see Jamie 4-0 at this point. But that's my pick. Next up is Huevos Gigantes versus Here Comes Trouble. Adam's coming into this 1-2. Trav's coming into this 2-1. If you've got any injury-prone running backs that you'd like to send to Adam, please let him know. With Grant, Steven Jackson, and now Ryan Terrain on his roster, he's pretty much collecting them, so feel free to give him a shout. As far as the matchup goes, this is actually a pretty close matchup, and it's a real hard one to call. Trav's starting two wide receivers that's going up against a top five pass defense. Adam's got one that he's starting. I don't like Forsett being in the lineup. You know, Steven Jackson's also a game time decision. I'm going to say that Adam probably takes this game unless Steven Jackson ends up not playing. And in that case, I would definitely say Trav wins this game. But for right now, I'm going to say Adam probably takes this and goes 2-2. Alright, next up we have our marquee matchup of the week, Team Dynasty taking on Rainbow Warriors. Both teams are coming into this 2-1. You know none of the good teams are playing each other when James is in a marquee matchup of the week. Favre and Romo are both on buys this week, so James is having to turn to Gretkowski. I do think that that's going to hurt James a lot in this matchup. He's staying away from his start all of New England strategy this week and putting Gonzalez back in at tight end. I don't think that's going to be enough, though, against Dave. He's probably going to move on to 3-1 at this point. So, unfortunately, James, I think you're done for in this one, son. All right, now we have our Toilet Bowl match of the week. We've got Mind Grapes taking on KC Reunited. Both Sean and I are coming into this matchup 1-2. think what it really comes down to is who can fail the least in this one. I got Austin on a bye and Colston being very inconsistent, so both of our wide receiver lineups look like hell right now. I do think it's going to come down to be a pretty close game. I'm going to get Mr. Tate's opinion on how he thinks my team is doing thus far.
He bitch ass think he ain't a step. Well, he ain't for a surprise. A rude! Painful surprise! Because sometimes it's about intimidation, you know. It's mind games.
So, Terry, do you think I'm going to win this week?
Hell yeah.
Well, there you have it, folks. Looks like I'm going to win over Sean this week. That's going to wrap it up for us this week. Good luck to everybody this weekend, and we'll talk to you next week. Take it easy.